Section 39. Vaisampayana said, "The mighty Bhishma ceased having said this. Sahadeva then answered Sisupala in words of grave import, saying, 'If amongst ye there be any king that cannot bear to see Kesava of dark hue, the slayer of Kesi, the possessor of immeasurable energy, worshipped by me, this my foot is placed on the heads of all mighty ones like him. When I say this, let that one give me an adequate reply, and let those kings that possess intelligence approve the worship of Krishna, who is the preceptor, the father, the guru, and deserve the Arghya and the worship already offered unto him.' When Sahadeva thus showed his foot, no one among those intelligent and wise and proud and mighty monarchs said anything, and a shower of flowers fell on Sahadeva's head, and an incorporeal voice said, 'Excellent, excellent.' Then Narada, clad in black deer skin, speaking of both the future and the past, the dispeller of all doubts, fully acquainted with all the worlds, said in the midst of innumerable creatures these words of the clearest import: 'Those men that will not worship the lotus-eyed Krishna should be regarded as dead, though moving, and should never be talked to on any occasion.' Vaisampayana continued, 'Then that god among men, Sahadeva, cognizant of the distinction between a Brahmana and a Kshatriya, having worshipped those that deserved worship, completed that ceremony. But upon Krishna having received the first worship, Sunita, Sisupala, that mover of force, with eyes red as copper from anger, addressed those rulers of men and said, "When I am here to head ye all, what are ye thinking of now? Arrayed, let us stand in battle against the assembled Rishis and the Pandavas and the bull of the Chedis." Having thus stirred the kings up, began to consult with them on how to obstruct the completion of the sacrifice. All the invited monarchs who had come to the sacrifice, with Sunita as their chief, looked angry and their faces became pale. They all said, "We must so act that the final sacrificial rite performed by Yudhishthira and the worship of Krishna may not be regarded as having been acquiesced in by us." And impelled by a belief in their power and great assurance, the kings, deprived of reason through anger, began to say this, and being moved by self-confidence and smarting under the insult offered unto them, the monarchs repeatedly exclaimed thus. Though their friends sought to appease them, their faces glowed with anger like those of roaring lions driven away from their praise. Krishna then understood that the vast sea of monarchs, with its countless waves of troops, was preparing for a terrible rush. Thus ends the 39th section in the Arghyaharana Parva of the Sabha Parva.